Hey all, today we are going to discuss about excess cavity preparation in posterior teeth basically. So we are starting it with the premolars and that too the maxillary ones, right? So the maxillary premolars, the site of excess opening is between the buccal and the lingual cusp tips, right? So it is basically from the central groove. So in this picture you can see this is the central groove and the site of excess opening is from this central groove, right, between the buccal and lingual cusp tips, right? So the outline form here also you can see in this picture is basically oval or slot shaped, right? Now this outline form is basically wider in buccolingual direction. This is wider in buccolingual direction and it is narrower, as you can see in this picture, it is narrower in mesiodistal direction. So this is the mesial and distal sides and therefore it is narrower in mesiodistal direction, which should correspond to the mesiodistal width of the pulp chamber, right? Ideally, it should not extend beyond this extension, basically the mesiodistal width, right? Now the buccal and palatal extension of this outline form basically. So the buccal extension is 2/3 to 3/4 up the buccal cusp incline, right? So this is the 2/3 extension of this buccal cusp incline, right? And the palatal extension is halfway up the palatal cusp incline. So this is the halfway up the palatal cusp incline, right? So this is the basic extension of the, or you can say the buccal and palatal extension of this outline form, right? So the buccal and palatal walls funnel directly into the orifices. If we have extended properly, then it will directly funnel inside the or into the orifices, right? The buccal orifice and the palatal orifice basically. Now the mandibular premolars. So mandibular premolars are basically different from the maxillary premolars because there is a 30 degree lingual tilt present, right? So the crown is lingually tilted in mandibular premolars and the shape of the excess cavity preparation, right? The shape of the excess cavity preparation is basically oval and which is wider mesiodistally, right? But in maxillary premolars, we know that it was narrower mesiodistally. But in mandibular premolars, the shape of excess cavity preparation is basically oval and which is wider mesiodistally, right? Here in this picture, you can see that this is the crown is lingually tilted. This is the mandibular premolar, right? And this is the maxillary premolar, which is not tilted at all, right? Here in this picture also you can see that the crown is tilted lingually relative to the root and mandibular premolars, right? So there is also a lingual inclination of the crown, right, in mandibular premolars basically. So as we have discussed, in maxillary premolars the site of excess cavity preparation was from the central groove, right, from the center of the buccal and lingual cusp tips, right? So this was the central groove, right? But in mandibular premolars, to compensate this inclination or lingual inclination, you can say the initiating point is from buccal to the central groove. So this is the central groove basically and the initiating point is from buccal to this central groove, right? Now there is also a difference between mandibular first and second premolars, right? So the mandibular first premolar are more lingually tilted than the second premolars, right? So the buccal shift or the starting point is more buccal to the central groove. But in mandibular second premolars, the compensation is not that necessary, right? It is nearer to the central groove. So here you can see that this is the central groove of mandibular second premolar and this is the starting point, right? SP or the starting point of excess cavity preparation is nearer to the central groove, right? Now we are going to discuss about the excess cavity preparation in molars. So firstly, we will discuss about the maxillary molars, right? So the external outline form is basically triangular in shape if only three canals are present, right? So the names of the three canals are basically mesiobuccal, distobuccal, and the palatal, right? But if four canals are present, that is MB1, MB2, right? Distobuccal and palatal, it will give a rhomboid shape to the outline form, right? Then we will have a rhomboid shape. In this picture, you can see that there is a rhomboid shape of the outline form, basically, right? Not triangular. Now, basically, if three canal orifices are present, that is mesiobuccal, distobuccal, and palatal, then the outline form is basically triangular in shape and we call it as molar triangle, right? But if fourth canal, that is MB2 is present, then it will give a rhomboid shape to the outline form. Right here in this picture, you can see that this is basically MB1, this is MB2, this is distal or distobuccal, and this is a palatal canal orifice, right? And if we join all these orifices, we will get a rhomboid shape, of the outline form, right? And Liupke called this preparation to be the shamrock preparation, basically, right? And it will give a clover leaf appearance to the outline form, basically, right? Now, this outline form is basically widest in buccolingual dimension, right? Now, the mesial and distal boundaries of this excess cavity preparation of maxillary molars. So, mesial boundary is the line connecting the mesial cusp tips, that is mesiobuccal cusp tip and the mesiolingual cusp tip, whereas the distal boundary is basically the oblique ridge. Now here in this picture, you can see the mesial and distal boundaries, right? So the mesial boundary is the line connecting the mesiobuccal and mesiolingual cusp tip, right? So this is the mesiobuccal and mesiolingual cusp tip, and we are connecting these lines. So this is the basically the mesial boundary, whereas the distal boundary is basically the oblique ridge, right? And this is the starting point, right? This is the starting point, which is basically on the central groove, right? Midway between the mesial and distal boundaries, right? And now the penetration of pulp chamber roof, right? So in molars, the penetration angle should be towards the largest canal. As we know that in maxillary molars, the largest canal is the palatal one, right? So the penetration angle should be towards the palatal orifice in maxillary molars, right? So this was all about the maxillary first molar. So the maxillary second molar is basically similar to that of the maxillary first molar, right? But the canal, that is the MB2 canal orifice, is less likely to be present in the second molars, right? So the, and also the three roots are found closer to each other, which may fuse to form a single root in maxillary second molars, right? So this was all about the maxillary molars. Now the mandibular molars. So in mandibular molars also, the external outline form is triangular or rhomboid. Triangular if three canals are present and rhomboid if four canals are present, right? So it is widest in mesiodistal direction. But as we have read earlier that maxillary molars were The outline form was widest in buccolingual direction in maxillary molars, right? But in mandibular molars, it is widest in mesiodistal direction, right? So the boundaries of the outline form of mandibular molars is the mesial boundary is basically the line joining the mesial cusp, right? And the distal boundary is line connecting buccal and lingual grooves, right? So here in this picture, you can see the mesial and distal boundaries. So the mesial boundary is the line joining the mesiobuccal cusp tip and the mesiolingual cusp tip, right? Whereas the distal boundary is the line joining the buccal groove and the lingual groove, right? Now the point of penetration into the pulp chamber roof in mandibular molar is towards the distal orifice. As we have read earlier, the point of penetration into the pulp chamber roof should be towards the largest canal, right? So the largest canal in mandibular molars is the distal canal, and therefore the penetration of the pulp chamber roof should be towards the distal orifice, right? In mandibular molars. Now the most important point is the starting point of burr penetration should be at the central fossa, right? Midway between the mesial and distal boundaries, right? So here it is, okay? We should also be familiar with the names of the canal orifices, that is mesiobuccal, mesiolingual, right? Distobuccal and distolingual, right? Now we are supposed to remove the chamber roof, right? This is done via safety tip diamond burrs or carbide burrs, right? In any of the posterior teeth, which is common for all. Removal of the chamber roof, right? Now we are supposed to identify all the canal orifices present in the posterior teeth, right? So it should be located at the corners of the final preparation, right? The orifices should be entirely on the pulp floor, right? Suppose this is the pulp floor. This is the pulp floor. And suppose this is the axial wall, right? If the canal orifices are extended into the axial wall, it will give a mouse hole effect, right? Which will cause atrogenic errors, right? So it should not extend into the axial walls, and the orifices should be entirely on the pulp floor like this, right? Now the next step is the removal of cervical dentine bulges and coronal flaring, such as in anterior teeth, as we have read, there was lingual shoulder. Similarly, there are cervical bulges in posterior teeth. So cervical bulges are basically shelves of dentine that overhang orifices, right? Restricting access into the root canals basically. So we have to remove this dentine bulges, right? So as to have a straight line access, right? So it can develop from mesial, distal, buccal or lingual walls inwards, right? Restricting the access towards the orifice basically. So it can be removed with burrs or ultrasonic instruments, right? And lastly, we should have a straight line access for a proper excess cavity preparation to be there, right? So rest, all the guidelines should be followed and all the objectives of excess cavity preparation should be fulfilled, whether it is anterior tooth or posterior tooth. So this was all about the excess cavity preparation in the posterior teeth, right? Thank you for watching.